Welcome, everyone. Dr. Thor here. Get ready for Gnosis. Well, we've come to a time and actually have been there for a long time. And I've been trying to put together a proper testing of products in general, meaning alternative products, manifesting products, business products, a lot of products, actually, even maybe some common stuff that I run into. I mean, there's an awful lot of junk out there that people are making outrageous claims for. And this is particularly true in the alternative science, healing, business in general, and some business stuff. Well, I decided I'm going to be going and testing these things, particularly in the new year. We're going to test all these people that make healing claims, that say how great their products are. All these things, we're going to test them. I'm a little sick and tired of these claims. You know, people that put out, you know, bottles of water conditioners that are $30 in plastic crappy bottles, and this is supposed to make water wetter so you're better for it, and insinuating that there's great healing benefits for these 5 cents worth of drops in a $30 bottle. You know, these kind of things need to be tested. Now, it's hard to make conclusive tests because to do that takes many, many years and lots of people. And this, of course, requires lots of money. That doesn't mean things can't be tested. Either something works or it doesn't. If it only works for a certain percentage of people, well, we know this is true to a degree. Not everything works for everybody. But should it work to some degree for almost everybody? Yes, it should. Similar to the products that I sell, they work for everybody. I've never had a failure with the products that I sell. They help everybody. What they don't do is create miracle cures and other things that so many people make so much money on claiming. Yes, they help you, and depending on where you're at, well, they could be substantial help or minor help. A lot of it has to do with the interaction with certain products. But since I've been involved in this industry for over 40 years, including looking into, which is a new interest of mine, but I have been in business for over 30 years as well, business opportunities, what are people saying? Who are these people? And we need to look into this. You know, I'm a little sick and tired of seeing all these claims on YouTube and other places stating how everybody's getting rich. That I opened this page and I made this amount of money. Well, what kind of proof can we get from these people? You know, holding up a bank statement doesn't exactly prove much to me. This is very difficult. Anything can be reproduced that way. You can print out figures all you want and put logos on other things. It doesn't prove anything to me. What percentage of people do they work with that have success? Well, I mean, you know, when it comes down to dollars and cents, starting a business, well, there's no way to argue if something works or not. It either does or doesn't. Now, unless you're selling something different or odd, but these people claim, well, I picked it up from nowhere. I used this one product, one site. I made $100,000. You know, these kind of things have been going on way too long. We look into people's backgrounds and they don't overly check out. People, when you look into Tai Lopez, well, it's very strange how he's made his money. Yes, there's a big book company ran by him and other questionable groups, but his background doesn't show it. Apparently, he was an insurance salesman and then got into bizarre dating clubs, data model, data millionaire. Well, that sounds very bizarre to me. And his partners were in the same dating industry. Yeah. Well, the whole idea is that we need to get to the facts of these things. What are they offering? What are their success rates? And, you know, you can't go to them and say, and this is the problem with so many things, you can't go to them and say, well, I want to find out what's your success rate. Well, they'll send you to the people who are successful. Well, how many of these people are really successful? You sold 1,000 programs. Well, how many actually made money from it, followed through with it, etc.? Now, some of it is not the fault of the producer. Does somebody even follow through with it? But that may be because the course sucks, too difficult to implement. Well, that's just as bad as having no course at all. So the business area is something we're going to look into. We're also going to look into all these claims from people. What are they actually doing for you? And there's a lot of, again, urban legend goes, Willard water, it's great for you. Flanagan's water, it's great for you. Well, what is it great for you? So we're going to talk about all these things and put them in a product testing reality and see if they have certain results. Now, we have people that have direct physical problems. Does it affect them? Now, we're not necessarily looking for a cure, but of course, that would be nice. But are they affecting the actual biological functioning of somebody that there's some sort of improvement? How do you judge it? How do you judge supplements and other things? Well, I'll tell you one thing. You certainly can see if supplements work for you to a certain degree. And if they're not working for you, should you even bother taking them? There are other people saying that all sorts of their products create well-being. They assist in this area and that area. Well, what is the truth to this? Can they be tested? How energetic are they? If they're so energetic, they should affect growing. So the whole idea is that you should be able to grow seeds and see a different difference from what is either treated by a particular water, a particular plate, something that's energetic. Are they putting out more energy to a significant extent? So there's an awful lot to be researched out there, and there are people making outrageous claims out there. And who are they? Who are they connected to? And this goes to a lot of people. What are their products? Who are they connected to? And what's going on? People should know the background of certain people. There are people making orgone machines that are Satanists and have been for years and state how horrible Satanists they are. Are you using their machine? Do you want a machine built by a Satanist? Well, I certainly don't want to support that kind of mentality. Do people know it and don't care? Well, that's another issue. But the bottom line is, who are these people? Who are they connected with? Well, this is a serious problem out there because there's all sorts of these. Publishers who have connections to odd. Now, I've publicized a lot of this already, and they seem to be all connected to Satanists. Regular publishers, and of course, every single occult publisher. Not every single, I guess there's some different occult publishers, but it seems to be that they are all connected, and they're all controlled. Well, this is another issue as well. So knowing the background is something that people should be informed about. But there's also plain and simple testing. If you want to disregard a lot of different attitudes and belief systems from people, are they producing products that are valid? What have they done? Some people are selling products, like several radionic manufacturers, for over 30 years, and there's absolutely no documented information on them. And some of these are very expensive. Well, I guess they keep hawking out there and they keep selling them based on their fantasy understanding of them. But what are the actual reports? So here again, it's difficult. But, you know, certain actual tests need to be done. Simple, straightforward tests. Do they work or do they not? And these can be formulated fairly easily. Things can be tested fairly easily. We can test them in their practical results. We can test them in their energy fields of what they put out. There's many ways that things can be tested, and they should be. People are making money hand over fist with a lot of bogus products. And, you know, the problem is this is what life is all about. Selling something garbage, like taking millions and trillions of dollars to put into failure militaries, failure police departments, failure medical industry. It seems to be the human way of doing things. And doing this and pouring more money into a dead, filthy hole is not going to help us. And this goes for the only people that really can bring the society any help, and that is the alternative people. People that claim they have this type of supplement, this thing has come out. But, you know, this is a billion-dollar industry, and people come out with supplements, and they all state how wonderful they are, and they cure everything. Do they? What are their effects? What are they doing? How are they made? Can we get any decent information on what they're doing? You know, a lot of supplements out there, and of course, are valid per some tests, but are you even getting that supplement in the bottles? Are you? Is that in that tincture, in that pill that you're taking? You know, there was a random test of this done in New York, and they found that a lot of supplements didn't have any of what was stated on the bottle. And because they're, quote, food supplements, they are not regulated. Well, I don't know, because you can't do that with food. You can't put that it's a cheese pizza, and then when you bring it home, there ain't no cheese on it. At the very least, that's fraud. So what is going on there? So I'm not sure that the labeling laws. We've got plain and simple fraud going on here. And the bottom line is that we can't, don't have the funds to test physical substance like that. But we can try and steer people in the right direction. You know, this has been a real problem. I mean, people are being misinformed. Things that are super low cost, certain supplements, that's because they're giving you an inferior quality, or they're using tiny bits of it. How do you know? Well, we're going to try and get through some of this, and some of this is out of our scope and our financial abilities. Other things are not. If people are going to come out and say something works and works to a degree, and they're sending you all these healing energies and other things, well, they better be able to back this up. And we are going to be following up on all of these people that we decide. And we're anybody who would like a product tested out there, or knows of something, or even wants their product tested, should contact us. And remember, really, I'm the only person with enough skill to test these subtle energy products through using subtle energy machines and other basic technologies. We do have what are energy type meters, which are kind of common out there, which do at least give you ballpark. But, you know, either something works or it doesn't. Does it have enough energy to stimulate growth of particularly seeds? Can they grow faster, bigger, etc.? This is things that can be relatively easily done. So if you've got something that's so energetic, well, better produce energetic results. And that goes for anything. So if you're stating these kind of results from a subtle energy product, and of course, that's what we're going to be testing mostly, subtle energy products, well, what results do you get out of them? You know, I've already personally tested some of these water supplement things, and they're all a waste of money. I think we can all take, in these tough, tough times, our $30 to $40 for these bottles of cheap chemicals that they're ripping you off to sell to you, and use it somewhere else. Because let's remember, these people that are selling alternative are no better than the criminals who are selling you bogus things as well. There's nothing behind it. They are selling you products to fill their pockets and nothing more. They haven't proven to do anything for anybody ultimately. And as I've stated, we can't take their opinion, even though I am happy to print and pass their opinion on of what they feel their product does and so forth, and our results. And is there a way that we're doing something wrong? So we'll work with sincere people to prove that their products are good. We will also do everything possible to make a product reach the expectation or the claims that they've made. I am here to get out to the general public potent products that work. And if you have one of those, we're happy to work with you. If you don't and you're selling bogus stuff, well, I'm also happy to let everybody know that at the very least, things are very inconclusive, and I personally didn't get the results from these products. So we will find out what goes on here. We will start bringing this out to the public. We need to verify the so many products out there that are making so many claims that are so expensive. Things are sold for super high prices that you use even often. Supplements have become outrageously expensive. You gonna spend $60 or $30 a month for a bottle of something? Well, there better be some quality there, and there better be some proper manufacturing. Where is it coming from? Is it tested? You know, we're gonna try and do a lot of this as well, but this is difficult. And the fact that anything that comes from China is in question is really sad, because everything comes from China. And how do we get any information on that? Is anything tested by a third party? Well, I wonder if any of this happens. Quite frankly, not only are we being cheated by the ingredients, we are probably being poisoned by the products themselves. Nothing that comes from the criminal Chinese can be in any way trusted. But what do you do? Well, you are screwed. That's your problem. 90% of the ingredients in all medications come from China, as is most things. Like, I believe all the vitamin C chemical that's made, not natural, comes from China. And it goes on and on and on of everything coming from China. I was told recently that most garlic sold in the United States comes from China. So they even, while they're having food shortages now, are selling you food products because they know they can grow these cheaply and sell them at a high profit. Why are they doing that to begin with? Why do we stand for it? And they better be tested. And they're not. And don't believe packaging, labels, or anything else. There is no law enforcement. Everything is a giant corrupt sewer, so we have to figure out for ourselves and what works. And part of this is figuring out what these so-called alternative technology items are. Bring your boom back bracelets. So many other things that are out there, and there's many products like that. Q-Ray bands, are they doing anything? Do they produce any kind of energies? And what do they do? And what are the gross energies? What are the better? And do they actually affect your spiritual energy bodies to some degree? Well, this is a big question. And people, surprisingly, are buying millions of dollars worth of these products, in sometimes even monthly. Is there anything there? Does it work? Well, you're throwing your money down the tube, where there are technologies that are on the horizon and coming even right now, that things can be changed into an energetic informational field that will gain much stronger results than these primitive chemicals that seem to do little, as well as the products involved with them. So this is a serious problem that needs to be addressed. And a lot of things, well, gee, they're nice little products. That's all they are. They're nice little products. And how do you understand the benefits of them? And people don't know how to use products as well. How do you get benefits from them? Do they last forever? Well, you know, a lot of things you get benefits from within 30 days. That's it. That's all they can do. They're not going to keep sending you energy. So these are things that need to be fully understood. So the testing product is on. The, quote, consumer reports of alternative technology is now being kicked in.